I just basically.
These are the templates. Printed them, two copies, and then joined them so the toner is darker. I'm using a picture frame to hold down everything. Negative photoresist film on the copper clad here. I sanded it with the 600 grit sandpaper, and then cleaned it with the acetone. So after cleaning it with acetone, I'm not touching the metal surface. I have to remove one layer and put it on the board and then iron it and expose it. Now it's ready for exposure. I'm using a normal CFL lamp. First attempt fails miserably. The light was more concentrated here because it was the CFL, and less on the edges, and it's all destroyed. Doing a test to see which is the best time for exposure. Looks like 14, 16 and 18 are the best times for this.
Okay, got a new, prepared a new board. This is with the photoresist on and ironed. Now I'll set it up. I have a piece of frame, the template. This is the template. This is the toner side and this is the back side. Now I'll put toner side down. I cut the film now on the edges so it's nice and clean. So I'll set up the, this is the, I close my, just bring the glass, and when the glass sits on it, it will make it nice and flat. Okay, the lamp is turned on here. And I just started it. It's gonna, this, I made it far from the board so that the exposure is even all over the board. This way it takes about 18 minutes with the, without the paper, so I would try to give it 20 minutes. It's getting darker already. Okay, timer is done. I stop the light. And this is the exposed area. It's a bit difficult with one hand. Okay, it's coming off again. Same as before. This goes in the developer solution. You can see it's not perfect, but hopefully it's gonna be good enough. Trying to use the washing soda as developer, sodium percarbonate. Trying again another time. An exposed area, removing the film. Now it's a fresh solution. Just to try to eliminate one of the problems. each of them. I will help the process by just scrubbing it gently with a brush, soft brush. But I had to change the solution a few times. And this is the final try, I believe, and its pH is 10.4, very close to 10.5, the recommended.
I have to fix it up a little, but it's pretty good now.
Ready for etching. Suppose copper becomes pink, which means the etching process started. Agitating the solution brings oxygen and helps regenerate the copper chloride.
Board has been etched. Many problems here, but I will use it anyway because I don't want to make another one.
Caustic soda and water, it's diluted about 1 to 10, 1 part caustic soda and 10 parts water. This will strip the photoresist.
Tinned copper. Testing the first row. The brightness is not the same because it's low power now.
Wired up as a constant current source. Eventually this will have its separate control board, but now it's just running over from the breadboard.
UV lights on and alignment lights on, only the red lights, then start the exposure. And these red lights, they are controlled individually